Hello, I'm Jamie. Welcome to another session of Vista Export Services. In this session, I'll be taking through some of the key parameters of Vray Frame Buffer. So without further ado, let's open the render setup and frame buffer. Open the Vray tab and expand the Vray Frame Buffer ruler parameters. And click on Show Last Vray Frame Buffer button. Let's go through some of its key parameters. This first button is the Show Correction Control. When you click it, it will display all the correction controls available for editing renders interactively. First, you have the Exposure Control settings, which you can click to enable. To expand the settings, simply click on the arrow button. In Exposure settings, you have the Exposure slider to move from left to right. You also have the Highlight, Burn and Contrast. Then you have the white balance with a temperature slider. If you want to control specific correction controls, simply click on Enable button. Then you have the other correction controls such as hue and saturation, color balance, which is similar to Photoshop. There's also the background. With background, if you enable it, you need to load up the Vray image file, similar to these ones here. To save out Vray image file types, we need to enable the Vray raw image file function and click on its toggle. Once inside the dialog, you can type in the name and enable the other options such as EXR and so on if you need to. After rendering, then the Vray image file type would have been saved and you could load it in a background image to control it. You can use it as a background or foreground. The same thing applies to the LUT corrections. If you wanted to control the LUT parameters, you'd need to load up the LUT file type. And we also have the OCIO and ICC image control types. As mentioned earlier, we can use all these functions to control the renders in a frame buffer. We can also use pre-saved Vray image files as the main renderer in a frame buffer by clicking on the Load Image button. Vray image file types contain all the necessary data to manipulate a raw render accurately. All color control settings displayed here on the right are linked to some of these buttons here. As you hover over and click these buttons, they will automatically enable the controls displayed on the right. So you've got the HSL color correction there, same thing. Color balance, same thing. The levels here. So every time you click there, that would be enabled straight away. These are the colors, the levels. The curves, same. Exposure control, if you got any of it, exposure settings there. LUT. Then we have the history button here. In order for the Vray Frame Buffer to save history of your renders, you need to set it up first. To set it up, click on a Settings toggle and choose History Settings. In the Render History Settings dialog, under History Directory, you can set the location by clicking on its Browse toggle and choosing the location. You can also set the maximum file size in megabytes of all renders saved in history folder. Alternatively, you can choose the Use Project Path. You can choose to save it manually in a frame buffer by unchecking or enabled autosave to save automatically. You can also choose to autoload color corrections. It's often left unchecked because most users prefer to save it manually, if and when necessary. Users often enable the completed renders only option. This function only autosaves completed renders into history frame buffer. You can also choose to clear and click OK. Once all is done, you need to enable the Vray Frame Buffer history button. Otherwise, your renders will not appear in the history frame buffer. And you have the channels A and B buttons to compare your renders against. This button allows users to copy whatever is being displayed in a frame buffer into the clipboard and later save it anywhere in your computer. This button allows users to save whatever channel has been displayed in a frame buffer, choosing the location and saving it. If you click and hold, you have other options such as save all image channels to separate files. So for instance, when you render an image with multiple render elements in a frame buffer, this option allows you to save them all at once, separately, under a given name. The next option is to save all image channels into a single file. This button allows users to duplicate whatever is being displayed in a frame buffer by clicking on this button. The region render allows users to click and draw the region to render in a frame buffer. The track mouse while rendering allows users to instruct Vray on areas to render by selecting the button and moving the mouse in a frame buffer. This action might take seconds or minutes depending on how fast your buckets are rendering. This button is for interactive rendering. This one is to stop a render, and this one is to render last. In here, you have the red, green and blue channels. Most of these buttons and parameters will be easier to understand once a render is in a frame buffer. So without further ado, let's start with our first render. Let's open the Render Elements tab and enable it. Let's click Render to test the scene. To speed up the renders, a white override material was applied to the whole scene, apart from the glass, windows, curtains, and the picture frame. As you can see, the latest render was automatically saved into the frame buffer history preview. The following step is to do another test render without the IES lights turned on. To do so, we are going to select one of the instance IES lights in the scene and open the modifier panel. Uncheck the enable function. All instance IES lights in the scene are now turned off. In a Vray raw image file section, let's rename it differently to prevent the previously saved file from being overridden. And let's do another test render. Now that both renders have been saved into the frame buffer history, we can load them in the frame buffer by double-clicking in their respective thumbnails. This one had the IES lights turned on, and this one had the lights turned off. We can also click the Compare Horizontal button to compare between both renders by sliding the line in the middle. Next, click on a frame buffer A to see both renders in a frame buffer. Use the middle line to slide from side to side and switch previews if desired. Now we can use some of the correction controls discussed earlier to edit the renders in a frame buffer. As mentioned earlier, all these render elements can be saved as separate files by choosing its option. Or load the pre-saved Vray image file. Finally, you can also add the lens effect settings in a frame buffer by clicking on this button. I personally prefer to edit final renders in post-production packages such as Nuke, Photoshop or After Effects, simply because of their vast tools and non-destructive workflows. This short video is part of a new course I've recently created from our Patreon page and blog. You can download the full course from our Patreon page or the links below. I hope you've liked this video. If you did, please like and share it, and I'll see you on my next one.